The second section of the chapter 1 is heat capacity. Roughly speaking, the heat capacity is the relation between heat into the system and temperature increase of the system. There are two extreme cases. The first case is no volume change. In most cases, pressure increases, and the heat Q is used for the internal energy E increase only. The heat capacity in this case is referred to as the isochoric heat capacity, or the heat capacity at a constant volume, CV. Therefore, CV is defined as the partial derivative of the heat Q with respect to the temperature T at a constant volume V, which is equal to the partial derivative of the internal energy E with respect to the temperature T at constant volume V. Equation 1.2.1. From the relation 1.1.6, namely the differential of the internal energy E is equal to the temperature T times the differential of the entropy S, CV, the heat capacity CV, isochoric heat capacity CV is equal to the temperature T times the partial differential of the heat entropy S with respect to the temperature T at constant volume V. Equation 1.2.2. The second case is the heat is used for internal energy increase and also for volume increase due to a thermal expansion coefficient is non-zero. The volume increase should be the most if the pressure P is constant. Then in this case, work is made done by a P dV, pressure times volume increase. Therefore, in this case, the entropy increase is equal to the internal energy increase plus pressure times volume increase. In this case, we define the isobaric heat capacity, namely, which is the heat capacity at a constant pressure, Cp. The Cp is therefore defined as the heat capacity, the partial derivative of heat into the system Q with respect to temperature T at constant pressure P, which is equal to the partial differential of the enthalpy H with respect to the temperature T at constant pressure P. Equation 1.2.3. The relations equation 1.1.9, namely the increase in enthalpy is equal to temperature times entropy increase. Therefore, the heat capacity Cp is equal to the temperature T times the partial derivative of entropy S with respect to the temperature T at constant volume P. Because The enthalpy H is equal to the internal energy E plus P pressure times the volume V. Enthalpy is larger than the internal energy E because the pressure and volume both are positive. Therefore, the isobaric heat capacity CP is greater than isochoric heat capacity CV. Equation 1.2.5. Let us derive the relations between the isobaric heat capacity CP and isochoric heat capacity CV. The total differential of enthalpy H, dH is, dH is equal to dE, the total the differential of internal energy, plus PdP, VdP, and PdV. The temperature derivative of the enthalpy H is therefore the differential of H, the enthalpy with respect to the temperature T, is equal to the differential of the internal energy E with respect to the temperature T, plus V times the differential of pressure P with respect to the temperature T, plus P times the differential of the volume V with respect to temperature T. Equation 1.2.6. At a constant pressure, the this dP dT term vanishes. Therefore, the partial derivative of the enthalpy H with respect to the temperature T at constant pressure P is equal to the partial derivative of the internal energy E with respect to the temperature T at a constant pressure P plus pressure P times the partial derivative of volume V with respect to the temperature T at a constant pressure P. Equation 1.2.7. The first time of the right side of equation 1.2.7 is similar to the isochoric heat capacity CV, which is equal to the partial differential of the internal energy E with respect to the temperature T at constant volume V. So difference is at a constant volume or constant pressure. Therefore, we should relate the partial derivative of the internal energy at with respect to temperature at constant pressure P and that at the constant volume V. The energy E, the internal energy E, can be a state function of the volume V and the temperature T. And therefore, we can write the total differential of the internal energy E is equal to the partial derivative of the internal energy E with respect to the volume V at constant temperature T times the differential of the volume V plus the partial derivative of the internal energy E with respect to temperature T at constant volume times the differential of the temperature T. Equation 1.2.8. The temperature derivative of the internal energy E is therefore the differential of energy, the energy E with respect to the temperature T is equal to the partial derivative of the energy E with respect to the volume V at constant temperature times the differential of the volume V with respect to temperature T plus the partial derivative of energy E, internal energy E, with respect to the temperature T at constant volume V. Equation 1.2.9. At the constant pressure, equation 1.2.9 becomes the partial derivative of internal energy E with respect to the temperature T at the constant pressure P is equal to the partial derivative of the internal energy E with respect to the volume V at constant temperature T times the partial derivative of the volume V with respect to the temperature T at a constant pressure P plus the partial derivative of the internal energy E with respect to the temperature T at a constant volume V. Equation 1.2.10. Then we substitute the equation 1.2.10 round E over round T at P is equal to round E over round V at P T times round V over round T at P plus round E over round T at V into the equation 1.2.7 round H over round T at P is equal to round E over round T at P plus the pressure P times round V time over round T at P. We have the partial derivative of the enthalpy H over with respect to the temperature T at constant pressure P is equal to the partial derivative of the internal energy E with respect to the volume V at a constant temperature T times the partial derivative of the volume V with respect to the temperature T at a constant pressure P plus the partial derivative of internal energy E with respect to the temperature T at a constant volume V plus pressure times the partial derivative of the volume V with respect to the temperature T at constant pressure P, which can be expressed as the partial derivative of the internal energy E with respect to the temperature T at constant volume V plus the square bracket the partial derivative of the internal energy E with respect to the volume V at constant temperature T plus the pressure P square bracket close times the partial derivative of the volume V with respect to the temperature T at the constant pressure P. Therefore, the heat isobaric heat capacity Cp is equal to isochoric heat capacity plus the square bracket the partial derivative of the internal energy E with respect to the volume V at a constant temperature T plus the pressure P square bracket closed times the partial derivative of the volume V with respect to the temperature T at a constant pressure P. Equation 1.2.12. So what does this equation means is the energy increase of the over matter by the temperature increase is due to the volume this term CV expresses the internal energy increase without volume increase. This term, namely this term, indicates the internal energy increase by volume increase, because this is the rate of the volume increase due to the temperature increase, and this is the rate of energy increase with volume increase. Therefore, this product is energy increase due to the temperature increase through volume increase. And last part, P times volume, this term, this factor is the mechanical energy increase, namely the volume, the rate of the volume increase with temperature times pressure. Therefore, this is the rate of the work done by the temperature increase at pressure. Next, let us try to express the relations between Cp and Cv using familiar quantities. So the problem is this term, the square bracket, the partial derivative of the internal energy E with respect to the volume V at constant temperature T plus the pressure P, square bracket closed, the times the partial derivative of the volume V with respect to the temperature T at constant pressure P in equation 1.2.12. So the from the equation 1.1.5, which is obtained from the first and the second law of the thermodynamics, and which is dE is equal to TdS minus PdV. Then the differentiation of this equation by volume at constant temperature leads to the partial derivative of the internal energy E with respect to the volume V at constant temperature T is equal to the temperature T times the partial derivative of the entropy S with respect to the volume V at constant temperature T minus minus the pressure P. The Maxwell's relation from the Helmholtz free energy F is the partial derivative of the entropy S with respect to the volume V at constant temperature T is equal to the partial derivative of the pressure P with respect to the temperature T at constant volume. So we kick out the entropy S from the equation 1.2.13. Then we substituting the equation 1.1.24 into the equation 1.2.13, we obtain the partial derivative of the internal energy E with respect to the volume V at constant temperature T is equal to temperature T times the partial derivative of the pressure P with respect to temperature T at constant volume V minus P. Equation 1.2.15. Then we substitute equation 1.2.15, the equation obtained in the previous slide, into the second term of the equation 1.2.12, which is the relation between the isobaric heat capacity and the isochoric heat capacity. Then we have the iceberg heat capacity Cp is equal to the isochoric heat capacity Cv plus square bracket the temperature T times the partial derivative of the pressure with respect to the temperature T at constant volume V minus P plus the pressure P. Of course, these two cancels, and times the partial derivative of the volume V with respect to the temperature T at constant pressure P. As a result, we obtain the isobaric heat capacity Cp is equal to the isochoric heat capacity Cv plus the temperature T times the partial derivative of the pressure P with respect to the temperature T at constant volume times the partial derivative of the volume V with respect to the temperature T at constant pressure P. Equation 1.2.16. Then the problem is the term the temperature times round P over round T at V times round V over round T at P in the equation 1.2.16. This can be expressed using measurable properties in the following way, using the chain rule, which is the partial derivative of Y with respect to X at constant Z is equal to minus partial derivative of Z with respect to X at constant Y over partial derivative of Z with respect to Y at constant X. And this denominator can be inversed and comes to the other product, then which is equal to minus the partial derivative over Y with respect to Z at constant X times the partial derivative of Z with respect to X at constant Y. Therefore, T times round P over round V at round T at V times round V over round T at P is equal to minus the temperature T times the partial derivative of the pressure P with respect to the volume V at constant T times the partial derivative of the volume V at with respect to temperature T at constant pressure P times the partial derivative of the volume V with respect to the temperature T at constant pressure P. So the partial derivative of the volume V with respect to the temperature T at constant pressure P appears two times. Therefore, we have here the power of 2 here, and inside of the square bracket, there is this term, round V over round T at P. And the remaining factor, round P over round V at T, is that comes here. And we multiply this term by a minus V, and we divide this term by the volume V, then volume V remains in the denominator. Therefore, we have a factor of the volume V here, and the factor of the temperature T here from this T. Equation 1.2.17. Then the first square bracket is the definition of the isothermal bulk modulus KT, and second term, inside of the second term, is the definition of the thermal expansivity alpha. Therefore, this term t times round p over round t at v times round v over round t at p is equal to the product of the isothermal heat capacity, isothermal bulk modulus kt times the thermal expansivity alpha squared times the volume V times the temperature T. Equation 1.2.18. Then we have the relation between the isobaric heat capacity Cp and isochoric heat capacity Cv, which is Cp is equal to Cv plus kT alpha squared VT. Equation 1.2.19. And Cp, this equation is can be written as Cp is equal to parenthesis 1 plus alpha times kT alpha VT over Cv times Cv. So Cv comes out of the parenthesis, and as a result, the Cv appears in the denominator. Then this alpha kT V over Cv is known as a thermodynamic Grünneisen parameter, gamma TH. Well, this is a definition of the thermodynamic Grünneisen parameter. Using the thermodynamic Grünneisen parameter, gamma TH, the isobaric heat capacity Cp is equal to 1 plus alpha thermal expansivity times the thermodynamic Grünneisen parameter gamma TH times the temperature T times the isobaric heat capacity Cv. Equation 1.2.12. Now, I would like to ask you one question. I don't understand the physical meaning of the equation 1.2.19. Cp equals Cv plus kT alpha squared VT. What is the meaning of the term kT alpha to VT? Or what is the difference of the isobaric heat capacity from isochoric heat capacity equal to kT alpha squared VT? If you have any idea, please let me know it. Let me introduce some example of a heat capacity. This diagram shows the isobaric and isochoric heat capacity of Pericles and Forsterite with increasing temperature at zero pressure. What we can see are as follows. First, the heat capacity rapidly increase with temperature at low temperatures. However, the increasing rate becomes smaller, and at high temperatures, the heat capacity gradually increase with temperature. And another point is the values of heat capacities are similar among different materials at high temperatures. And the heat capacities are slightly higher than 1 joule per gram per Kelvin at high temperatures. The isothermal isobaric heat capacity Cp increase more rapidly with increasing temperature than the isochoric heat capacity Cv. This is because the factor 1 plus alpha gamma THT to the isobaric heat capacity to the isochoric heat capacity. So because of the temperature T is here, therefore Cp increase more rapidly with increasing temperature than isochoric heat capacity, especially at high temperatures. However, we note that experimentally, the isochoric heat capacity is almost impossible to measure, because especially for the minerals, because it is almost important to keep volume constant at high temperatures. And however, the isochoric heat capacity CV is easier to treat theoretically, because the volume increase is a secondary factor for the theoretical treatment. So this is the end of the section 2, heat capacity of the chapter 1, thermodynamic properties.